Okay, so recording has started. I request all the children to please stand on your place and we can start the national anthem. Everyone stand on your place.
Growing businesses host a solution that is powerful yet easy to manage. It helps us look.
जनगणमन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल वंदा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय जय
Yes, children. Yes. So now I request Denul Asmi to please give the welcome speech. Denul, on your video and give the welcome speech.
Yes.
Yes.
Please on the video. Good morning, everyone gathered here. This is Denul Asmi, brand ambassador of Igniting Dreams of Young Minds Foundation. It is my pleasure to welcome you all and thank you to each and every one of you for being here with us today. We are very pleased to be able to welcome those of you who have been with us today for the workshop. We are very proud and really happy to host this workshop at the beautiful place Sikkim with you all. Once again, I warmly welcome you everyone. On behalf of Igniting Dreams of Young Minds Foundation, I would like to express my sincere thanks to all of you who generously helped us to make this event come together to become a success. We could not have done it without you. I warmly welcome our Honorable Chief Guest, Mr. Anurag Behra, facilitator, NASA Human Rover Challenge Program, NAVSAT. I feel grateful to welcome the great NASA students, Amit Panigari sir, Nitesh Patnaik sir, Tani Malik sir, Rishikesh Ambit Naik sir. Also, I welcome Mrs. Zenith ma'am and Engineer Ravishankar Kumar sir, who are a great guidance for our team. I welcome our dear students who are set to make this event a remarkable one. And Igniting Dreams of Young Minds Foundation main aim is to promote space and satellite education for every young mind, that is for the entire student community from any schools and colleges all around the world. Well, I hope workshop based on satellite technology will help you to improve knowledge and skill. So I request everyone to utilize this golden opportunity of Igniting Dreams of Young Minds Foundation. Take a shot and join with us on this wonderful journey. With all enthusiasm, I welcome you all once again to the momentous event. Today will be full of fun and learning. Have a great day.
Thank you, Denul. It was an amazing speech by you. I request NASA team to please take the charge for today's workshop. So please proceed, sir.
Thank you so much. And just I would like to add one thing to what Denul said. So Amit Panigrahi sir is one of the mentors along with us. He is not a student. He is a mentor along with me. So we both are colleagues basically. And so now we shall take the charge together. Thank you so much. It has been an honor honor to be here with you all students. And the enthusiasm of every one of you maintaining the social distancing, wearing the masks and sitting in the classroom to attend a workshop on a Saturday, it's really a commendable thing. So to start with, I would just like to narrate a small story. So it's about a kid. That kid was sleeping on the lap of his grandma on a bed which was placed somewhere near a place from where the sky was visible. And what did the kid do throughout the time at night before he fell asleep? He was counting stars. He was trying to make patterns with the stars. Next day he goes to school and he learns about, there is something called as a Saptarshi constellation, which you students might have heard about, Arsha Major, Arsha Minor constellations. So he starts to find that every night, he tries to trace that every night, that pattern. He gets too much into that, that even the dots on bricks that is present in the walls of his room, he tries to make that pattern there as well. So if you analyze, then from the very childhood days, the sky has always been a mystery, and a mystery hole filled with a lot of enthusiasm and curiosity. It fills us with a lot of curiosity. Like if today a student of your age or of age little younger than you, if that student starts to talk anything about life in Mars, water in moon, such stuff, even the barber who is cutting your hair leaves his work and listens to you, because the space is such vast, it's so big, and it's so curious and endless. The deeper you go, the more you get out of it. And being Indians, we always have it in our DNA, like since the very beginning. The other day I was going through one platform, probably its name is Awakened Indian Platform or something like that. So there they were mentioning about like the earliest of the astronomical stuff that has been done in the humankind history, it has always been from the Indian minds. Maybe it's not the case today. Today we always aspire about being a NASA scientist or someone from ISRO, but a small observatory project that is happening in India somewhere in Nizampet in Hyderabad might be intriguing us to go and pursue space research or astrophysics. But if you see by our own history, we have been the astronomy superpower of the world for 3/4 of the time period that humankind has yet lived on Earth. So being Indian, being from such a culture, from such a place where we come from, by default, this thing has been in our blood. That's the reason why even after marriages, there are many rituals in our culture, in different events which we carry out in our lives. We have special mention of the sun, of seeing the pole star, because by default we have inculcated such things into our curriculums, through our culture, through our traditions. And when I was a kid, younger to you or even elder to you, a kid elder to you back then, in those days, the informations related to the space technology and all, it all seemed to be very, like, maybe this is what the reason why so many of us like about space, about satellites, about astrophysics, but we don't pursue that career because it starts to seem a lot, what you can say, like inaccessible, or I need to learn a lot of hi-fi physics and hi-fi mathematics, then only I can pursue this career. So that's what we generally tend to understand. But in real sense, if you see, then in the current world when we have so much of information around us, and the division of space science, astrophysics is having such an immense amount of curiosity by default induced into us, that once we try to venture into it with the flow. Now, for example, now I am interested about to learn about a black hole. Now what I can do is I can read about black hole, how it is formed, and then if a physics related to it is needed to be understood, a mathematical equation related to it is to be understood, that's when I have to learn. So if I take that approach, then I don't think the space science looks very inaccessible. That's how you learn everything, right? Even in maths, while seeing a Pythagoras theorem, you don't come by learning the whole Pythagoras theorem and sit in the class. What you do is you see a triangle, then you see the areas of the base, the area made by the square, taking the base as its side and height as another square, taking the height as its side, and then the hypotenuse taking the side, that area. So it's the square, is the square root. So that, how to find the length of it. So it is the square root of the addition of the other two. So basically, that's how we have learned everything. So space tech should not be treated like something of an alien thing. And always we have been linking the space learning, learning related to the space technology, astrophysics, to finding life out of Earth. It's fine. In some movies, they will say that humankind was born in Earth, but not meant to die here. It's fine. But now we are not here to die. Our life has just begun. So if you see, now this has been an era where we are slowly understanding that space technology is not just about finding life outside, but it's also about having a lot of ventures. There are so many elements outside. Now we are talking about dark matter. In the dark matter, we might be finding certain elements. We might be finding certain interactions between different planetary objects, which might help us in certain technological implementation in the Earth. At the same time, currently, because of the availability of internet, because of the world getting so shrinked, everyone coming so close, that's the reason why even in such a pandemic situations, we all are meeting here. We all are meeting. I'm here sitting in Bangalore. Amit sir is sitting there in Odisha. Tanvi, Rishikesh, Nitesh, all are in Odisha. Denul, I suppose she is in Tamil Nadu. And we all are coming together. Ravish sir is from Bihar. So we all are like sitting together here just because we have certain satellites which are revolving around. And yes, there is other aspect to that as well. Even the greatest of literature persons, like a poet or a writer, has always taken an inspiration from a sun or the moon to give their best literature pieces. So that's the depth that the sky gives you. So that's where I would like to request all of you that never think that this whole thing of astrophysics is going to be pursued only by the people who have very high-fi knowledge and things. The knowledge develops in the process of learning. You should just try to follow your curiosity. And earlier you never had organizations. Like now you have Igniting Dreams of Young Minds Foundation. You have foundations like us. Here we are like trying to provide you kids, people who are curious about this. We are trying to provide them with an environment where you learn about such things, where you get expert advices, expert guidance, and proper environment where you are not spoon-fed with the thing, but where you are actually like getting the real encouragement to learn it through challenging your own limits every time. That's the reason why we see Tanvi Malik, a student of class 9th, is challenging a project of NASA Human Rover Challenge. And our team is the first ever high school team that has attempted and successfully attempted to do so from India. So we have so many foundations around. And you guys have great scope in this field. So over to you, Amit sir. Amit sir, probably you're on mute.
Okay, sorry. Okay. So first of all, thank you, Igniting Dreams of Young Minds Foundation, for giving the opportunity to sharing the knowledge to these students. And I will address one thing, like there are so many fields. Suppose you want to go in mechanical field after your schooling, or else you want to go in biology, or else you want to go in electronics and electrical field. But space is something that requires every kind of people. It requires almost every kind of people. Suppose you have interest in, suppose I am giving an example, like if you have an interest in images or pictures, okay, like you are really liking to click images or analyzing images. So you have the opportunity to excel in that field also. Like, you guys must know that Google Maps is there, which is completely based on images and live images. So satellites are taking images of the Earth, and then we can analyze that, and we can also work on that. So this is not some like a specific field of the ground. Space and astronomy, this field, it requires every kind of people. You have interest in anything you want to pursue your career in. Now, in present scenario, we have the opportunity. Like in the previous days, in our childhood, we don't have much wider reach of gathering knowledge from different resources. But now we have a really, we have internet. Okay. So in internet, we can access everything by internet, and everything is in the world is now actually getting closer. Like in previous days, we have to go there to gain some knowledge. We have to go to some university, but now knowledge is everywhere. Knowledge is free. So like in our days, only some big giant space research organizations like NASA and in India, ISRO were there. But now also some private companies like SpaceX and Skyroot, which is an Indian startup. Skyroot, they have developed an indigenous rocket engine. Okay, so it's not just for only now, this is not the thing that only you can get to this astronomy field by having an aerospace engineering degree. You can also go if you have an expertise in any field. If you have that passion, if you have that interest towards these astronomy and research, then you can excel. I think, yes, you students are really the coming generation. Yeah, you are the generation, we all expect you to be better than us. Okay, so whatever you choose to do in your life ahead after your schooling, I think you must have a wider vision, and space and astronomy giving you that field. Okay, so that's all I want to say.
And earlier, students, the space technology was more about researching only the planets, researching about is there water in moon. But now, if you say, then every aspect of life is being controlled by few satellites. So like that would be a good point to note nowadays, that satellites and big antennas in order to feed the satellites have become an infrastructure in everyone's life. So earlier, space technology was just the part and parcel of lives of space scientists. But now, because of that space technology, you have a Google map. When you are going from your village to another village, there is a map that shows you the path. So now the satellites are actually making our lives simpler day by day. They are being part of our local lives, of a general commoner's life. And
exactly,
there has been, there is a work going on in the world where they are trying to do the telephone communication. Now, as I understand, you are in Sikkim, you are in the hill areas, so internet reaching to you guys is a bit difficult. But the new work that is going on, as per that, it will be just a satellite sitting in space, which will be communicating directly to your phones. So definitely there will be some changes in technology, but that is a concept coming up now. So internet will no longer be needed with a separate broadband or a specific data connection in your phone. It will be available like the phone signal everywhere. So it's making satellites even more a closer part of every one of our lives. And today, if you want to find out a 50-year-old data related to your village, your city, even about your own house, the top view of your own house 50 years ago. You can just go to ISRO's Bhuvan platform and you can see, you can get that information, which is 50 years old. That's just getting your lives so close with the satellite, because it's the satellite which is actually now giving us the kind of stories which we used to hear in fictions, that they are observing us and they went to the past to see how that fairy tale unwraps. Like, they went to the past, how they that person did such and such thing. But now the Bhuvan platform of ISRO is actually giving you 50 years old data about your own village, including the number of rivers that is going through, the way the water is being distributed, how your village used to look in those days, what was the forest coverage back then, population back then. So that's how the satellites are being part of our lives every day. So I would now like to request our students. So, like, first of all, so our team lead of our team is Rishikesh Amit Nayak. And before that, I would just like to request Amit sir to just describe a brief about what is being done in our organization to appreciate students like you, because that's what is our concept as well, to get young minds into space technology. Because now the world has opened up recently to the space, and it has opened up to our common lives, not just the high-tech life.
Exactly.
So Amit sir, please explain about that.
So I will talk about the journey we have started. Okay, so first in September, we have decided to have a team, and we have decided to have a student's astronomy team actually. Because this is something that will really inspire a lot of students out there who thinks that school is a burden and getting knowledge is boring. It's not like that. It's a very fun activity. And then we have created a team and recruited, and from about 800 plus students, we have selected these 10 young and passionate students like Rishikesh Amit Nayak, and we have with us Mitesh Patnaik, Tanvi Malik. And so then every year NASA is organized this rover challenge, like that calls as a NASA HERC competition, Human Exploration Rover Challenge, for both the high school students and for the engineering students. So we have decided to take part in this, and we sent a proposal, and then fortunately, and fortune favors the best, that's how it works, and we got selected in the NASA Human Exploration Rover Challenge 2021, and then we are working on it daily. And like, the students are now studying in 12th, some are in 11th, some are 10th, some are 9th. Still, they are managing both the things, both the challenge and their studies. So you can see that that much amount of passion is must to pursue and win in every field. So this is how our journey started, and our team name is NAPSAT, Navan Mesh Prasad Student Astronomy Team. Okay. So that's all, guys. And I am handing over this charge to Rishikesh Amit Nayak, our team
the
leader.
Team.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you, Igniting Dreams of Young Mind Foundation, for inviting us. Thank you, Amit sir and Anurag sir, for describing about satellites and about describing over the team. I pass on to Tanvi, our junior most member of the team. She will start with the presentation.
Yeah, thank you, Rishi Bhaiya. A very good morning to one and all present over here.
I'm Tanvi Malik, the marketing lead of NAPSAT, the Navonmesh Prasad Student Astronomy team. First of all, I would like to thank the Igniting Dreams of Young Minds
Foundation for giving this amazing opportunity to all of us.
So I would like to start with the journey of Team NAPSAT through these amazing months. So I'd like to start with myself first. So since childhood, I have been interested in science and astronomy. So since I was a child, I believed that Earth is not the limit, that there exists something beyond that, that we would like to explore. And I got into innovation in sixth grade. So as an innovator, I was curious 24/7, and I thought that there must be something amazing beyond Earth that I want to pursue. So I came to know about the Navonmesh Prasad Foundation, that is our parent organization, and about NAPSAT. So I applied for the team and I got selected. So I was really excited when I got selected. And after that, I got to meet my team, and it was filled with amazing people. So after that, we had only one goal in mind, to represent India at the NASA Human Exploration Rover Challenge 2021. So we applied for the same in October 8th, and we waited and waited till November 6th. And finally, the big news got out. We had got selected. Now we are the first under 19 interdisciplinary team from India to get selected for the NASA Human Exploration Rover Challenge 2021. So far, our journey has been really amazing. It is not all smooth, because we have faced many challenges. For example, the main challenge is the COVID-19 pandemic. Till now, our full team has not yet met. We just met yesterday, and also without our educators, because they were busy in something else. So COVID has made it really difficult for us to meet and manufacture our rover together. But still, we are pushing through, and still we are trying our hardest to make this a great success. And hopefully by the time we get to see you all again, then we would be sitting here being the first under 19 interdisciplinary team from India with an award at NASA Human Exploration Rover Challenge 2021. So this journey has been amazing so far. About space technology, I would say that space has a place for everyone. It does not matter what you're interested in. It has a place for anyone. It will accept anyone, because it is a vast, vast, vast concept. And if you're interested in biology, you can study on the sustainable development on Mars, like the NASA is now aiming for the Artemis mission. And they want to improve the sustainable development on Mars by 2028. So related to that, biology is related. And then we have, like Anurag sir said, Amit sir said, then we have GPS, which we use on a very, very daily basis, but it is connected to space. So space is much closer than we think, and it is
not as complex as we think.
If you think that we need like high maths and physics for that, we don't, because I myself am a ninth grader, but I somehow still got into space technology. The biggest reason is that because I'm curious and I'm interested in that. So I wanted to pursue something in space technology, and I did. So I would like to invite all of my friends to space technology, because it is a very interesting concept. And once you enter, I guarantee that you would not like to leave. So now I would like to invite Rishi Bhaiya to say something as the team leader.
Thank you, Tanvi.
No, Rishikesh, you are on mute.
He will be continuing with the further presentations. The design lead, please.
Yeah, so thanks, Rishi, for so I am Nitesh Padnaik. I am the design lead of the rover team. When I was in class 8, I used to watch the Cosmos in Nat Geo. So from there I got interest in space science, and astrophysics. So there, there they used to say about the all the planets, and they used to teach us the viewers about astrophysics and some concepts of it. So from there, I I was very curious about the space science thing. So from there I class 8 I was very interested to go in this field after watching that show. So when I got an opportunity in NAPSAT, so I applied, and fortunately I got selected. It was not an easy process to break in, but I somehow managed to be into the team. So then after getting into the team, the main problem about the challenge got started. I am the design lead. So the first thing when you think when you are manufacturing a rover is its design. So I was the I am the guy who is responsible for the first step, for the initial step. So it was very difficult in the initial time to get used to the team, because I was I don't know anyone of my team members. So it took some time to get used to my team members, and then we communicated very frequently, and then all the process was very smoothly going on.
There is one thing, Nitesh. Yeah. Sorry to interrupt you. I would like to just share a nice story how Nitesh got selected to the team. So, because of certain circumstances, Nitesh wasn't able to attend the interview at the scheduled time, and the time had already passed.
Thanks, Nitesh. Coming to the overall team, I'm the proud team lead of the Indian team, first Indian team, under 19 team that's been selected to represent India at the NASA Human Exploration Rover Challenge. So basically, I won't be talking anything technical, not about the how we started, but about the struggles and the challenges we faced in the overall team. When we started the journey, what struggles we did, and how we are, where we are standing currently, and what's the position if we compare our team with the other international teams of the challenge. So basically, when we started, challenge in August, when Amit sir, Anurag sir, they were there with the interviews round. We had 3 interviews done. It was a very lengthy process, and it was literally out of my. It was not a usual interview that we give in somewhere where we are asked about technicals or anything stuffs. We were asked about everything, about managing the team, managing about the technical stuff, about satellites, about the rovers. So when the process started, after a week, we were we had the inauguration of the whole team, where we had to know about the whole team. Then we just got to know that this will be the final team, and we'll be starting with the work. But then also we started with the problems of the team, there were certain problems going on. We had some students they couldn't manage to make up to the team because there were some issues with the time and all. We processed that problem because where we were selected of the 10 students, two of our members were not there. So we are 8 members left, but we had then Anurag sir, Amit sir, then again, they went for another selection. They went for other 2 members. There were 2 other good guys, they are in the team currently. We got the selection done for them. Then we started with the problem statement. First statement, when we hear that there was no earlier Indian team to be selected in the NASA Human Exploration Rover Challenge in the high school category, that is just a major setback. That how can we be selected? Since last 40 years of the competition, no teams were selected. So why, how can we be special and how we can do that? A major setback was there, but there was a constant motivation of the educators of NAPSAT along with the mentor, like our founder Anil Pradhan sir. Like he guided us that they hadn't done, but yes, we can do because we are the best and we are unique than others. Like the other teams, like that already have participated, but not from India. They couldn't do that because they were somewhat lacking out, but we could do that because yes, we are capable of that. Then on November 6th, we got the results out from NASA and like for the first time we got selected. After that, we had to start with the manufacturing of the rover. We had to start with the designs, but then another challenge came, Nitish, the designs had some issues. The suspension part has some issues. So we had to redesign it again. That took again some parts, like since November end week, we had to complete with the designs, but it took around December 5. So we had to solve that problems. Again, we are planning for a major record of Guinness, like for the STEM engagement activity. Like in the last years of the international teams, they have assembled of 7,500 students in STEM engagement. Because in the competition, we have to focus with the rover along with the STEM engagement activities. Because NASA focuses on STEM engagement rather than the rover only. Because it's not the only 10 of us that will be going to represent India. But that should be the motto, that we are the 10 students representing the other 20,000, 30,000 students from India at NASA. So for that, we had to prepare a plan for STEM engagement, because 20,000 STEM engagement is not a small number. So if you are going for a 20,000 plus STEM engagement, we'll be planning for a Guinness Book record and Limca Book of Records. So for that, we had to plan our strategies, and we are currently progressing for a good, better STEM engagement in that field. So currently we hold a very good position in STEM engagement, along with it, the rover manufacturing. Again, I'm just showing a video, like it's about our design.
Please present the screen.
Is my screen visible?
Rishikesh ji, please present. Yes, yes. It's visible. Yeah.
This will be a four-wheeled mechanically driven rover. Like one boy and one girl will be sitting and they will be mechanically driving it. The terrains are planned according to the Mars terrain, so that in 2024 in the Artemis mission, one woman and one man will be sent to Mars along with this rover. So for that, we are designing the rover for that challenge. So it's basically the design and the 3D simulation done by Nitish only.
Are the students here, the school students, or have they disconnected from the call?
No, sir, they are there, sir. They are there.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
Once again, Rishikesh ji, please play once again, because I think there was some network error in that area.
Okay.
So they have connected now. Sorry, yes, sir, right. Thank you, sir. Arnak, sir, you are right. So yes, Rishikesh ji, please play once again and explain everything.
Surely.
Unfortunately, network was gone. Okay.
Surely. This is basically the rover design. The rover design and the stimulation done by Nitish Patnaik. Here, one woman and one man will be sitting. It will be a mechanically driven rover, like four wheels and a mechanically driven rover, which will be sent to Mars in 2024 in the Artemis mission. So in the Artemis mission, NASA and along with it, other 8 countries are planning for sending one man and one woman to Mars along with this rover. So for that, the competition, they're planning the terrains, like the terrains where the rover will be driven. it will be the terrains of Mars only. So for that, the rover has been designed of, it's the 3D design and the stimulation done.
Rishikesh ji, please explain each part, how you have made it, and
yes,
each part how it is helpful for NASA mission.
Yes, sir. And Nitish will take the lead. Nitish, please.
So the main chassis part of the rover will be the main frame you can see in the video. I'll just request him to play it. It shows the main frame. So this is the main chassis of the whole rover, where the total weight and all the forces will act on. So designing this is the first step for the rover. Yes,
sir. The main challenge is main challenge of the frame was like how to fold this, because the main frame that we see, this part, it has to be folded into two parts, because NASA has provided the challenge that the main frame should be folded into five foot length, breadth and height into 5 foot 5 foot dimensions. So the main challenge was how to fold the main frame and how to lock it. So here we can see like the this joint is there. Here it will be getting this this part will be getting slided into it, and here the holes are there. It will be locked. Means this hole and this hole will be locked with the like one rod or anything. It will be locked it. So the main issue was how we have to fold the main frame and how we have to lock that. So that was one of the main challenge. Along with it, I'm saying about the other challenges we had faced. These are the gear hubs and hub holders. Like this depends on the how we'll be calculating the, it will be, how we'll be using the speed and torque, so that we generate a exact speed and torque that's needed by us in the for. Acceleration of the whole rover. These are the other small nuts and bolts, like where it has to be fitted on. Wheel boxes, like where the wheel will be fitted in. Like this was the initial design we had planned of. Along with it, like we had changed some designs accordingly. Like Nitish, can you present that? Can you present the current design? So basically, the Rover Challenge, like, it challenges on basic how to traverse in terrains of difficult terrains, like in their plan for the Mars terrains this time, like there will be marshy terrains, there will be the boulders, there will be sand, how to traverse through them. There are 14 obstacles. How many teams will be completing the obstacles? Accordingly, the result system is there, and Nitish, he will be sharing the current designs, because it was the initial design that we had sent to NASA. After that, we had some modifications done because we need to be unique in somehow. So we modified it again and again. Nitish, please.
Nitish ji, I request you, when you speak, please on the video. Nitish ji, it's my request to you.
Actually, the camera is not there. He's using my laptop.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, fine. Yes, so children, as you can see that how this, it's a proud moment for our country, ma'am. We are now 140 crores. And only one team got selected from India, and that is a team from Odisha, our own state of India, right? So it's a great moment, and it's a great guidance by Anurag sir and Amit sir. That's how they have reached to this height. And I hope that in coming year, in 2024, this rover will go to Mars, and it will make our country proud, and we will host our flag in Mars also. So it's a very, they are very small kids, you can see in the video, and they have done it. So the purpose of conducting this seminar for all of you is to encourage all of you to please come up and join with us and work on this project. And you can also dream to be in NASA. You can also go there and you can make your country proud. So I really salute this young scientist, age of 14 or 15 years old only, under the guidance of two young mentors. Not very old, they are also very young. And really, when I see a scientist, they are 50 or 60 year old. But here I can see a scientist of only 20 years, 14 years. That's a great thing. So take this opportunity in a positive way, all of you, a student of Sikkim, and you come up with some idea and join with us, and we will help you to build this. Yes, please, Rishikesh, hand over to you.
So basically, this is the current design that we are working on with. One person will be sitting in the front. He will be driving with the drive. This is the drivetrain, and the other person will be sitting exactly to the back. This will be the drivetrain for the second person. We are using a triangulated frame, because a triangulated frame, it increases the strength. Along with it, it also helps us in getting the folding mechanism. Like here, this can rotate. Yeah. So in this bottom part, in the middle, we are using the folding mechanism, hinge mechanism. In folding beds, if you guys have seen now, there are folding beds. The mechanism using the folding beds, we are using the same mechanism, and we are using a nut for locking the whole system, because the challenges said that it has to be folded into two parts and it has to be locked out, so that they will keep that whole rover in a complete solid box, and it has to fit that solid box. Otherwise, if it doesn't fit, we'll be disqualified there. So the main challenge was how to fit and how to fold this whole mechanism. Again, on the other part, can you show the suspension, please? The main problem with the triangulated frame, its major advantage is it provides a great strength, but there are issues with the suspension part. They are currently also working with the springs and the joints, the A arm. This is called the A arm, the bottom part. It's called the A arm. This A arm has to be connected, and how the whole rover will be capable of holding the weight of two person, it has to be done. So the main issues were there, but they were been solved out. And currently it's been manufactured. I'm presenting the where it's being manufactured. And they are not the school students, but they are the IT students. Like after plus after 10th we go for a education. If we go for a good education, we go for a plus two. These three students are from a very rural backgrounds of Odisha, like from the exterior parts of Odisha. One is from Ganjam district of Odisha, one is from Mayurbhanj. Like these are the very exterior parts of Odisha, but they come upon here and they showcase the talent and they got selected. So it doesn't matter from where you belong or where you stand, but it does matter is how much dedication you give for a particular project or particular team, and also along with it, how much passionate you are for the job. Like if you are representing India, you have to dedicate at least a huge amount of time. Along with it, you have to go for a good time management, because as you can see, like Tanvi, she's from 9th. She is managing her studies, like she's managing her studies for 3 to 4 hours. And again, she's back with the work for 9-10 hours. Same with me and same with Nitish. So we are managing both the things in a positive way. So it always matters how much sacrifices, like if we come upon the sacrifices we've done, like we ignored our personal life completely. Like since the last month, last two months, we don't have our personal life. Like we ignored our friends. Like not ignored, but we don't have a good contact with our friends. We don't have a good relation with the school. Like because sometimes we are not able to attend the classes also, online classes. So we have like. Personally, I had to drop out my two startups and like I had to do a lot of sacrifices. So same with Nitish, like same with Tanvi. So whenever there is a sacrifice, there is a positive output. If we don't go for a sacrifice, we won't be getting a positive output from there. So a request, like if you're going for some kind of project, like for the state or for the country, please like dedicate yourself like that much level that you have to be focused, complete focus on the project that you are involved in. Because any other thing comes in your mind, like you will be getting distracted and you cannot give your 100%. We are trying for our 100%. Although being humans, we cannot give our 100%, but we are trying for that. So just a request, like if you are involved in any kind of project, give your 100% for that. I'm showing the screen for like the work going on currently.
Yeah, so guys, as you can see that Rishikesh is very young, and I can see that Nikita also, all are very young kids. So the mission of conducting this workshop in Sikkim, and Vinod sir, I really salute him for organizing this program. You can see that they want to inspire you, come up with idea and work with the team, and you can go for NASA. NASA is in US, you can go fly from India to US and you can represent your country. Yes, Rishikesh, hand over to you.
Thank you, sir. She's a girl welder. Like she's welding the mainframe. This is the mainframe. It's been done in the Skill Development Institute of Bhubaneswar, Odisha. And she comes from a very, very rural background. Like her story, like is a great inspiration for everyone, because wait a second. Yeah. So her name is Reena. She comes from a very rural background. Like since past COVID, she didn't had any educational qualification. Like till she had a education qualification of 10th, but after that she had came here to Bhubaneswar for a rural in a slum area actually in Bhubaneswar. She stayed with her with her uncle's house. She doesn't have the father, unfortunately. Her father passed away in the birth near birth. So she had came here to visit her uncle's house, but due to COVID, she had to stay with her uncle's house. Her uncle and aunt, they both are laborers, daily laborers. Like after COVID, like after 1 month of COVID, their family ran out of the errands. Like they ran out of money, and these girls, like she and her sister, they have to work. They had to work. Like they searched for works. But due to COVID, no one accepted her to work, because she wanted for a job like a maid, but no one accepted because due to COVID. So what she did, she went to a welder shop. There she requested to make them learn about welding and experience them about welding, and then she can start her journey. Like she can earn out at least some 10,000 money of or 10,000 or 15,000 money for the family to run, because they had to survive. So from a welder shop in Bhubaneswar, he started that shop started training them, and later like they were in 1 month of time they learned many things in welding. So that made them recognize about in the ITAs in Bhubaneswar, like government ITAs, they made them recognized that yes, these girls can also weld, because there is a stereotype thinking in all over India also, like girls cannot weld, like these welding kind of things they are pretty dangerous and girls cannot do that. But she proved that yes, girls can do, and from there like she got selected. She like our educators, like our, these are like gods for us. Amit sir, Anurag sir, they like and the other educator team, they saw the potential and they then selected them, and they were referred from the ITAs only. They didn't got selected, but they were referred being the best students of IT, and they were in the team. So it doesn't matter, like you are a girl, you are a boy, your caste, your rationality, anything, your background, your family background, anything, it doesn't matter absolutely. Like if you have dedication, if you work according to your passion, if you got talent on that, you can do anything, literally anything. So just focus on it, focus on what you are doing, get your talents out, like, because if they can do, why can't we? Because we are privileged that we are getting a proper education system. They don't have the proper education system, but they are doing that. So why can't we? So basically, on that note, like I would like to sign off. Thank you.
It's really a great inspirational talk by you, Rishikesh ji, and all the team member of NASA team. And it's a proud moment for all of us to hear their great speech. And I think the student who are sitting in Sikkim right now, they're very inspired by your talk. And yes, Anurag sir, you want to share something? Then I hand over to Lela ma'am. Then Janet will take the charge, and then we'll end up the session. Yes, Anurag sir, you want to say something?
No, just I wanted to like ask, yeah, like if students have some questions, they can ask us, or else we can.
Yeah, yeah. Binod sir, can you just ask the student to ask you, say you the question that you can post in the message box? That will be great. Or you can take the mobile to them, and they can easily connect with us. Binod sir. Yes, he will go, sir. I will give the handover to mic to Lela ma'am. Please, Lela ma'am, managing director of IDYM Foundation, please give the motivational speech. Hello, Lela ma'am. Hello, Lela ma'am, can you hear me? Lela ma'am, I think she is not able to unmute your mic. Okay, fine. Children, I will play one PSLV launch animations. Where you can see that how our India have various rocket system like PSLV, SLV and GSLV. Right now we are working on HLV system also. So India have made a various kind of rocket system, and as Amit sir and Anurag sir and all the team member of NASA, we are telling to all of you that now we are connected with different satellite and different technologies. So this India is working basically on two system. Now after a few days, India is going to launch PSLV 50 series. So India are going to make a half century now in PSLV series. And all of you know that Mars mission, it was not possible by PSLV rocket, but India is the first country who launched Mars mission with the help of PSLV. It was a great thing. And also guys, we have made a satellite called Pratham. It is right now in ionosphere, atmosphere have different series. So in this ionosphere is also there. So it count number of electrons. I just like to play one video animation video PSLV, and I request Binod sir, please please give the chance to the student for asking questions. Please, Binod sir, can you hear me? Yes. Now, sir, you can see in the comment box, Binod sir reactions for all of you. Just see the message box. I request to Anurag sir and Amit sir, just check the message box, comment from the school authority. Yeah, and see how he's inspired by the talk given by all of you. It's a proud moment.
Yeah, it was our honor as well. It was our honor as well, yes, to be part of all this.
So yes.
Growing businesses need a hosting solution that is powerful yet easy to manage. Let's look at how business.
That this is the four stage rocket PSLV and it has got separated into four parts. First stage will be separation of booster part that you can see there are four boosters connected with this, And then there will be another three stages will be taking place. At the last stage, there is a separation of satellite. It will come out from the rocket. And satellite has got a solar panel. How the satellite get energy? That will be your question in mind. Satellite will get energy with the help of solar panel, because with the help of this solar panel, they get the energy and they rotate in the orbits. So this is how a satellite works. India has got PSM, India system. GSLV is also called Fat Boy. So it was made, it is made by India only. During Mangalyaan launching, India was unsuccessful to test GSLV. So India has gone with PSLV and we made it. Yes, Anurag sir, so yes, I request all the students ask the question from school side, because scientists are waiting for all of you to ask the question. I request all the students, please kindly ask the question. You know, sir, can you just ask the student if they have any questions? You can take the mobile for, in front of them, they can ask the questions. You know, sir, can you hear me? I think he's not able to unmute himself. Now I request Janet from Tamil Nadu, so kindly, sir, can we end the session here? Yeah, I think he has got connected up, you know, sir. So I think after vote of thanks, we will go to him. Okay, sir, Anurag, sir?
Yes, sir, fine.
Okay, Janet, please kindly give the vote of thanks of today. Yes.
A warm and graceful greeting to our most valued honorable Chief Guest, Mr. Arun Behra, facilitator, NASA Human Rover Challenge Program, NUPSAT, and the great NASA mentor, Igniting Dreams of End Mind Foundation, Government Senior Secondary School, Temi, Sikkim, Vati teachers, students, and my dear friends, and everyone gathered here. It's my privilege to propose a vote of thanks and acknowledge the contribution of those who worked really hard to make this workshop on satellite technology even for us. First of all, I extend my most sincere thanks to the Almighty God for making today's event a resounding success. With His blessing and grace, we are able to make this event what it was. And our Igniting Dreams of Young Mind main aim is to promote space and satellite education for every young mind, that is for the entire student community from any school and college all around the world. We involve a group of people with several years of experience in education, ranging from the people of education ministry, various schools and college principals, and young talented space and enthusiasts. Igniting Dreams of Young Mind perform workshops, lectures on space and satellites for every school and college with discussed speakers with multiple IITs, ISRO, DRDO, NASA scientists, and many such space experts. I'm short of words. Last but not least, a big thank to each and every one of you guys who make this workshop joyful with the express explanation of satellite technology. We're enjoying on each and every one of us present here. On behalf of Igniting Dreams of Young Mind Foundation, I extend a really hearty vote of thanks to NASA Human Rover Challenge Program, NUPSAT team, members of great presentation and making today's event a resounding success. Once again, thank you everyone for being gathered here with us today. Thank you.
Bino sir, can you hear me? Let a student ask some question, because scientists are very much excited to answer their questions. They are also very young kids. Yes.
Yes, sir.
Bino sir, please connect with some student. Things are good because fluctuations. That's why they're not okay. Okay, sir. Vinod sir, can we end up the session or what, sir? If some questions are there, I will ask them to us and then we will answer. Anurag sir, can you hear me?
Yes, sir, I can hear you.
Yeah, can we end up the session, sir, with your permission?
Yes, sir, fine. Amit sir, is it fine?
Amit sir, is it fine for you and all the team member of NASA? Sure. And one more this thing, Vinod sir, can we end up the session now? Yeah, if any queries of any students are there, please post to us. I will pass to NASA team and the NASA team will answer this. Having some network issue. So thank you everyone. NASA team, salute you all. First team of India, get selected thank for you. NASA. It's a proud moment for me as an Indian that you are from the same country. And I really thankful to all of you because especially Anurag sir, I was troubling him by sending so many messages to come for this program. And he really, one request I sent to him and he agreed for this. Thank you so much, sir. And he came along with all team members. It is not that only end of, this is the first program of NASA team. We are going to have long journey together and we will create a history. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Definitely. Thank you. It was our honor. It was our honor to be here. Yes. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much. And we will end the meeting here. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, please, a student, please leave the meeting and all the other members who are present here.